We want to give a special thanks to Mattel for sending us this free gift. Star Wars Barbie. Previously on Unbox Daily, we reviewed the Princess Leia inspired doll. Now, get ready for R2-D2. The Star Wars R2-D2 Barbie doll is available for pre-order at barbie.mattel.com, priced at $100. Currently, it's available to ship on December 16th, 2019. If you scroll down, we have lots of fun information, like the release date was August 13th, 2019. The designer is Robert Best. All of the Star Wars dolls are gold label, which means quantities are limited to 20,000 worldwide. This product is intended for adult collectors and is not intended for children under 14 years of age. Inside, we will find the doll, a doll stand, and a certificate of authenticity. The R2-D2 Barbie has blue packaging. There is a drawing of R2-D2 on the side here. On the other side, it says Star Wars and Barbie. On the back of the box, there is the symbol for the Rebel Alliance, just like Princess Leia's, and it has the same description on the back. Let's carefully remove this to open the box. Now we can see the entire doll and some really awesome sketches on the sides. We have R2-D2 on one side and the doll's concept art on the other. I really like her facial expression right there. Let's take her out of the box for a closer look. Lay the box down, carefully pull out the tabs so we can open it at the bottom. Then we can pull the doll out. I need to remove all of the securing plastic to free the doll from the box. The certificate of authenticity is located on the back of the insert. She comes with the black Star Wars stand, and I don't think we took time to show this in the last review, but it does have decorative images on all four sides. This doll has the Model Muse body, which is the same body used on the Barbie basic dolls. She has two straight arms and the basic 5 points of articulation with movement at the head, shoulder, and hip. Her hair is a very rich blue. It is the exact color you would expect to find on R2-D2. She wears it in a high ponytail with hair wrapped around it. The hair is long and straight and past the waist. She has blue eyes with dramatic eye makeup over one eye. I like the soft lip color, but that eye color pretty much locks this doll into this character. Well, I guess you could say she just really likes makeup, or she's in an 80s inspired band. Her fingernails are colored in a soft pink. She wears a white vest with gray stitching on the sides. That's a pretty shiny thread, and the pattern kind of reminds you of a bubble jacket, or bubble vest, because this doesn't have sleeves. There is a little puffy trim around the top of each shoulder, a blue ribbon stitched at the side. There's a white trim that goes around the edges. The inside is lined all the way around. Yep, all the way around with a metallic silver fabric. It even has a little Star Wars Barbie tag. It has a large hood that is also lined with that silver metallic fabric. There are no openings in the hood to allow the doll's hair through, which I really like because that's how real hoods are made. The hood is large enough to fit over the doll's head with all of her hair. It has a nice high collar, which I like, and there is a large metallic circle on the other side. That's a very cute little R2-D2 touch. Under the vest, she's wearing a sheer sleeveless top with lots of metallic rectangles on the front in silver and blue. It has snaps in the back so it can be removed. However, there are a couple of stay stitches holding it onto the dress. If you're still inclined to remove it, underneath you will find a strapless dress Well, it has those clear straps, so it looks like it's strapless, even though it's not. The top is metallic silver, connected to a white waistband and a sheer skirt with rectangles. There is a small plastic plate in the front, right around the waist. It is stitched to the sides. It has blue details. The skirt has a very boxy shape, which reminds me of the top of R2-D2. Under the sheer skirt, she is wearing silver biker shorts that stop just above the knee. They are covered by long faux leather white leg warmers or leg cuffs. I don't know the official title for this, but they give the illusion of really tall boots, when in fact, they stop right past the ankle. She wears white wedges with a painted copper heel and a little silver painted detail on the side. I like the rectangular pattern printed onto the faux leather. All these little details are just amazing. However, I would have liked to have seen the belt go all the way around. She wears gloves on both arms that have printed details, and the fingers are out. On one arm, she wears two plastic bracelets and carries a gold-colored purse that can open. The vest is definitely one of my favorite elements about this doll. It's kind of bulky, but I don't mind it. And I'm a big fan of layering. The Star Wars dolls are also available for pre-order at Barnes & Noble for $99.99. So it looks like you can save a penny by going with Barnes & Noble. I think it takes a lot of creativity to make a fashion outfit out of R2-D2's look. And while some of the pieces are definitely Star Wars, there are a few items that we could add to our everyday mini wardrobe, like this vest. Let us know in the comments down below if this doll is a buy or a pass. Thank you for joining us while we took a look at R2-D2 Barbie. Be sure to check out our Princess Leia review and keep an eye out for Darth Vader Barbie. Like, comment, share, and subscribe. Don't forget to ring the bell and follow us on Instagram at MyFroggyStuff and the Frog Vlog. And we will see you next time for another Unbox Daily. And that's our collection for now.